Tonight, the House Intelligence Committee will allow its members to review the report that Democratic staffers have been writing, detailing the president's role in the Ukraine scandal, meaning tonight we're going to learn about the committee's findings from this phase of the inquiry. But right now we're learning that Republican staffers have prepared a report of their own, and CNN's Manu Raju has reviewed it. Manu, what can you tell us?
Well, it's a 123-page report essentially rebutting the Democratic allegations that the president abused his office, engaged in bribery in his handling with Ukraine, pushed and withheld foreign aid to military aid to Ukraine at the same time as pushing this foreign power to investigate his political rival. Instead, what the Republicans are saying that everything the president did was had a reason. They're saying that the president was within his rights to push for Ukraine to do just that because of it's his concern about the history of corruption in the country. They say the president did nothing wrong, and they are arguing this 123-page report that we have obtained. It shows that they believe that essentially the Democrats' allegations fall flat. Now, this is what they say. They said the Democrats their goal since day one has been to impeach this president, they say in the beginning of this report. Then they go into some of the allegations detail by detail, saying that there's no evidence to back up the Democrats' claim. They say at one point the evidence presented does not prove any of these Democrat allegations, and none of the Democrats' witnesses testified to having evidence of bribery, extortion, or any crime or misdemeanor. Now, they go on to talk about why the aid was withheld to Ukraine, why that meeting was withheld as well. They say that the evidence, in their view, shows something different. They say the president's action was, quote, entirely prudent because of Ukraine's long history of corruption. Then they go on to talk about more about what the witnesses have alleged, and they say it does not back up the Democrats' claim. So this is not surprising, Jake, because the Republicans have been making these arguments for some time. We heard them make this in the 2 weeks of public hearings. But what's going to happen in just by tomorrow is that this report will be the minority of views that will be essentially adopted to the larger report that the Democrats are putting forward. Now, that larger report is going to detail the Democrat side of the argument, in which they are going to argue that the president certainly did abuse his power in office, and we'll wait to see what they recommend. But that will lay the course of articles of impeachment that will almost certainly be voted on in the House before the end of the year.
So just to underline this, Manu, the idea that we're hearing from House Republicans on the Intelligence Committee is not just this doesn't rise to the level of impeachable. They're saying that President Trump did nothing wrong.
Correct. They're saying everything they did is, quote, entirely prudent. That is what they're saying, because of their argument that the president was simply concerned about Ukraine's history of corruption. So he had the right to review that security assistance. He had a right to deny that meeting with President Zelensky of Ukraine because of his concerns, they say, with corruption in that country. Now, that is their argument. Clearly, Democrats see it much differently. They're saying they're going to point to the witness testimony that they believe undercuts what the Republicans are saying.
That's the Republican rebuttal from Manu Raju. Tomorrow, the Intelligence Committee is expected to vote on whether to send its impeachment report, drafted by majority on the committee Democrats, to the House Judiciary Committee, which will then hold the spotlight, starting with a public hearing on Wednesday. The White House has already declined an invitation to take part in that hearing. But as CNN's Alex Marquardt reports, the White House still has until Friday to decide whether to participate in any future hearings.
Order. The passing of the impeachment torch. In the next few hours, the House Intelligence Committee is wrapping up its role, finalizing a report for its members to review behind closed doors, detailing findings of their 8-week investigation into the Ukraine affair, which included historic open hearings.
The impeachment inquiry into Donald J. Trump, the 45th president of the United States.
That report marking this next phase and setting the stage for a big week when the House Judiciary Committee takes over, tasked with drawing up articles of impeachment before the full House votes on impeaching the president.
I think the evidence is being presented to us by the Intelligence Committee really focuses on the Ukraine matter, so as well as the obstruction. If we do articles, and that's not a foregone conclusion, that would be the central thrust, I would assume.
Now driving the process is Chairman Jerry Nadler of New York, whom the president has known for years.
Lo and behold, I come down to Washington as president, and who do I have again? Jerry Nadler. I know him well. I've had great success against Jerry.
The first judiciary hearing is on Wednesday, with a lineup of experts to talk about the constitutional grounds for impeachment. But the president and his Republican allies are already slamming the process.
It's an internal kind of time frame to try and finish this out by the end of the year because they want to get at this president right now before before everybody completely sees through the process sham of the elections for next year. So we're rushing this.
The White House has declined an invitation to take part in Wednesday's hearings, but could still choose to participate in proceedings after that, meaning they potentially could call their own witnesses and cross-examine others. The president today making that seem unlikely.
The whole thing is a hoax. Everybody knows it.
So the White House still has until Friday at 5 p.m. to tell the Judiciary Committee whether they'll participate in the hearings after the first one on Wednesday. Chairman Nadler responded to the rejection of that one just a short time ago, saying that if the president has nothing to hide, quote, he would turn over the thousands of pages of documents requested by Congress, allow witnesses to testify instead of blocking testimony with baseless privilege claims, and provide any exculpatory information.
All right, Alex Marquardt, thanks so much. Let's chew over all this news with our panel. And Mary Catherine, let me start with you. One of the excerpts from the Republicans on the House Intelligence Committee, their rebuttal, says, I mean, in which they say President Trump, not only that this doesn't rise to the level of impeachment, but that he did nothing wrong. One of the quotes, the Democrats' impeachment inquiry is not the organic outgrowth of serious misconduct. It is an orchestrated campaign to upend our political system. The Democrats are trying to impeach a duly elected president based on the accusations and assumptions of unelected bureaucrats who disagreed with President Trump's policy initiatives and processes. Is that how you see it?
Okay. There is a lot of evidence that many Democrats have wanted to impeach him from day one.
Absolutely.
Right? So there's that. There's also a lot
especially
of evidence.
Especially the ones that introduced articles of impeachment
right.
back in 2016.
There's also a fair amount of evidence that he did a bad thing and that the phone call was not perfect, right? Both of these things are true. And I think polling does not bear out that many people think it was perfect, right? The argument is basically, is this impeachable and removable? There are a lot of people who think it was inadvisable or wrong, but maybe they're not willing to go there. That's where the argument lies. But the interesting thing about this strategy, which I don't agree with the assessment, but it's not really hurting the president or Republicans because they landed probably the hardest and cleanest punch they were going to have last week, Democrats did, and polling has not moved greatly in favor of impeachment, which sort of confuses me that that happened, but that's the facts on the ground.
So that's the true. It hasn't hurt them politically, but does it hurt? Let me just make it a little bit broader. Does this hurt the United States, the idea that it's okay for a president to do this? It will be okay for President Buttigieg to tell China, you need to look into Jared Kushner's sister and those visas that they've been offering, or for President Elizabeth Warren to say to the president of Kazakhstan, there's a Trump Tower there that I think we need to learn more about.
Exactly, and that's the way forward if you accept that this is the rightful behavior. You mentioned China, of course. Donald Trump has asked China to look into the Bidens, not just Ukraine. I think the problem, of course, with this House Republican report is they've taken the president's advice. Remember, he was getting angry at them, that they were only defending him on process, not on substance. Now they're like, substance, you did nothing wrong. They say that he had genuine and valid concerns about corruption in Ukraine. If you believe that Donald Trump cares about corruption anywhere, I have a certificate from Trump University to tell you. This is the most corrupt president in modern American history. He just settled a case of his own last month for misusing funds from his own charity in his 2016 election campaign. Paid a $2 million fine, so maybe he should investigate himself. So I just don't buy this argument. It's not gonna hold, even a Republican. Everyone knows that Trump doesn't care about corruption, whatever your view of Trump is. And on the politics of it, I don't know. 50% in the CNN poll say they support, 50% of Americans say they support impeaching and removing Trump. That is before a single article of impeachment has been drawn up. It's definitely ahead of where polls were at this quote-unquote phase of the Nixon process.
David, you're an advisor to the Trump campaign. I think you have said that you don't think that the call was perfect.
I don't think the call was perfect. Again, I don't think it was anything illegal. The Department of Justice already opined to that. And let's listen to President Zelensky's own words again today. He gave an interview today to the German magazine Der Spiegel. We said President Trump and I didn't talk about quid pro quo. We didn't talk in those terms. He doesn't understand. The president of Ukraine doesn't understand what the issue, big issue, is here. Why does he have no weight to this at all? His testimony has nothing to do with this.
He can say, laughing, so we'll let
Jen's laughing because she says, oh, what's he going to say? Then the president will punish him. The president's not going to punish him. The entire Congress, the entire United States would rise up if he did something to backlash.
Well, David, first of all, I think you're ignoring what you know better, which is how it works in foreign policy and the power of the United States with countries like Ukraine, where the most important relationship for President Zelensky is with the United States. That continues to today. He doesn't know what's going to happen with President Trump.
So let's.
So President Zelensky's not telling the truth.
Let me just read the quote.
So two presidents aren't telling the truth.
I don't know if this is your time or dear Spiegel, but this is the quote from Zelensky. Look, I never talk to the president from the position of a quid pro quo, Zelensky said. That's not my thing. Quote, I don't want us to look like beggars. But you have to understand we're at war. If you're our strategic partner, then you can't go blocking anything for us. I think that's just about fairness. So let's remove Zelensky from this for one second, because obviously you have two different interpretations of those remarks. Do you think that this is a wise strategy for the House Republicans to just say the president didn't do anything wrong here?
Listen, that's the cards they've been playing so far, and I agree with Mary Catherine. They might not be the best cards, but they're moving forward pretty handily. I think the polling has shifted. It's shifted away from impeachment somewhat. And I think that
in the battleground states,
Yeah.
Particularly among independents, which is important.
And again, Mary Catherine's talking about among independents. I think that when, again, I'll say 31 Democrats sit in Trump-won districts, 13 in Romney-McCain Trump districts, okay? So those Democrats, when it comes time to vote, are they going to walk the plank knowing that Donald Trump's going to be acquitted by the Senate a few weeks later?